Hi children, welcome to social class. Today we are going to learn about the new lesson, the post Mauryan kingdoms. Aim: to explain the main features of the Sungas, Kanvas, Satavahanas, Indo-Greeks, Parthians, Sakas and Kushanas. Students, what is this symbol and who made it? Do you know? This is symbol of the four-seated lions, is our national emblem. These lions are actually carved on a huge stone pillar at Sarnath. This stone pillar was built approximately 2000 years ago by Emperor Ashoka. He was the ruler of the Mauryan Empire. In India, the first ever empire was founded around 2300 years ago by Chandragupta Maurya. He started expanding the boundaries of the Mauryan Empire by conquering the neighboring areas. Chandragupta Maurya had an advisor named Chanakya or Gaudilya, who helped him in expanding the Mauryan Empire. Chanakya wrote a book, Arthashastra. After Chandragupta Maurya, his son Bindusara became the next emperor. When members of the same family become rulers one after another, it is called a dynasty. Ashoka, the son of Bindusara, was considered to be the most famous emperor of the Mauryan Empire. Ashoka was the first emperor who communicated with the common people of his empire through inscriptions. Ashoka wanted to conquer the Kalinga. Therefore, he waged a war against Kalinga. Ashoka was sad after the Kalinga war as he saw a lot of people die on the battlefield. So, he following Dhamma. Ashoka's Dhamma teaches us about the way of living and respecting people. The Mauryan Empire ruled for about 150 years. Thereafter, many new and smaller kingdoms rose to power and ruled over different parts of the subcontinent. Some of the important kingdoms that came to power were the Sungas, the Kanvas, the Satavahanas, the Indo-Greeks, the Parthians, the Sakas and the Kushanas. The Sunga dynasty that came to power after the decline of the Mauryan Empire. Pushyamitra Sunga founded the Sunga dynasty by killing the last Mauryan king. Pushyamitra ruled from Magadha. Pataliputra was his capital city. During the reign of the Sungas, art and literature flourished. Important books such as the Yoga Sutra and Mahabhashya by Patanjali and Ashtadhyaya by Panini were written during this period, and Madura School of Art also flourished in this time. The last Sunga king was Devaputi, who was killed by his own minister Vasudeva Kanva. Vasudeva was the founder of the Kanva dynasty. The Kanvas were supposed to be Brahmins. When Vasudeva Sunga came to the throne, the Sunga rule was already over. Punjab was ruled by the Greeks and most parts of northern India were ruled by other rulers. Next, we are going to learn about Satavahana dynasty. The Satavahana dynasty started ruling over the Deccan region of modern-day Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Maharashtra, parts of Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat in the west, Bihar and Odisha in the east from about the 1st century BCE to 3rd century CE. The founder of this dynasty was Simuka. He was succeeded by Krishna. The dynasty reached the peak of its success during the rule of Gautamiputra Satakarni. He is a important king of Satavahana dynasty. Although they followed Hinduism, the Satavahanas were tolerant towards Buddhism and promoted both Sanskrit and Prakrit languages. The Satavahanas were also patrons of art and architecture during their rule. Next, the Indo-Greek kingdom was founded by the Demetrius in 1st century or 2nd century BCE. The kingdom extended to parts of modern-day Afghanistan, Pakistan and parts of Northwest India. The most famous Indo-Greek ruler was Menander, who was said to have become a Buddhist. During the two centuries of their rule, a new form of art and architecture called the Gandhara School of Art came into existence. The Gandhara form of art combined both Indian and Greek style while creating the sculptures of Buddha. The Indo-Greeks also combined India and Greek language and symbols in their coins. Next, the Indo-Parthian kingdom that included parts of present-day Afghanistan, Pakistan and northwestern India was ruled by a group of kings from Central Asia. The founder of this dynasty was Gondoparas. Taxila was said to be the capital of the Indo-Parthians. Next, the Sakas were a nomadic group from Central Asia who established their rule in the northern and western part of India. The founder of the Saka dynasty was Maus. The Sakas ruled from around 200 CE to 400 CE. Rudraman was said to be an important king of Saka dynasty. Next, we are going to learn about Kushanas. The Kushanas belonged to the nomadic tribe called Yuchi from Central Asia. Kaniska is said to be the greatest of all the Kushana kings. He started ruling from around 78 CE and founded the Saka era, the calendar that we follow in India today. Kanishka followed Buddhism and promoted the religion. He sent Buddhist monks to China and other parts of Central Asia to spread Buddhism. Kaniska also promoted art, architecture and literature. His court included famous scholars such as Ashwakosha, Nagarjuna and Vasumitra. He had many Buddhist stupas and monasteries built in Taxila and other parts of his empire. He promoted the Gandhara School of Art. After the end of Kaniska's rule, the Kushana Empire became weak and broke into smaller parts. Okay, students, today we learned some important post-Mauryan kingdoms. Thank you, children.